Hello traders, how are you today? In this video I'm going to show you how to work with very simple indicators and how to manipulate them, how to use them in the way that they will give you an edge. I'll show you two simple indicators today, but before that, don't forget to subscribe or give me the like button at the end of this video if you like it. As well, during this video I will tell you the settings for the indicators I'm showing you, so bear with me to the end. Let's start the rock and roll. So I have already prepared the indicators, which are here. They are very simple. It's simple Bollinger Band or Bollinger Band and the moving average. The special thing about them is that they've got a special settings. They got special settings and they are different one from the default one. I would recommend you or advise you to work over the settings of all indicators you are using during your trade. As example, I can give you, let's say, stochastic. When you get the stochastic, whatever it is, the simplest one, yeah, which is, well, basically, I don't recommend to use them. You got 533, which is very fast settings, is default setting. When you click reset button, you'll always get back to this, the settings. Look how it looks like. How would you trade with that? There is no way, even if you make it bigger, I assure you, you will lose your money. So try to experiment with every indicator you've got. I give you an example on stochastic, what you should do. For example, if you get it and instead of 533, you make, let's say, 111, and here we get 1212 to make it simpler, all right? So look how it looks like now. It's absolutely different. At least you can read something from the chart, wouldn't you? Look, it's very simple. You sell here and you buy here. Much easier. So I just encourage you to experiment with all those indicators. But I'm not going to talk about stochastic right now. So let me close this sugar here. So what we've got here, I told you, is a Bollinger Bands. Look, they look like that. I prefer to trade them on 1 hour chart or 4 hour chart because they work pretty well as the smaller time frames like M30 or even M15. They work fine, but the higher time frame, the better. I'm telling you, because on the lower time frame, you got a lot of market noise and usually you will get wrong signals much more often than on the higher time frames, like 1 hour time frame or 4 hours time frame. So look, it's much less those signals, and it shows it's more reliable over here. When you get the signal, it's bigger chance that you get into the trade on the right side of the market, then you don't get chopped off. And on a smaller time frames, usually you will be chopped off very quickly by the broker, by the market makers, by big banks, whoever, because they know where is your stops, they know where you got take profits, because they see it. You cannot see that, but they can and they do. They know exactly where your stops are and take profits are. What I wanted to show you here, simple Bollinger Band, look how the market behaves over here. As soon as it comes to Bollinger Band, it just get rejected after a couple of candles as well. It's 20 candles, so it's 80 hours, 3 days. But as the market stops here, you could expect that the market at the moment will reverse. It doesn't happen always. I'm not saying that, because pretty often the market very often keeps long time below the lower Bollinger Band or keeps long time above the upper Bollinger Bands. It's not the case, but when you see on a smaller time frames, it happens pretty often. Look, like here, for example, market stays a long time under the lower band. So even if you bought here, you lose money. If you bought here, you probably lose your money, and so on. But on a higher time frame, it works pretty nice. Usually, I used to work on 1 hour and 4 hour charts with this indicator. So this line in the middle is moving average. It's moving average. I give you the settings later on. Just stay with me a while. What is characteristic for Bollinger Bands? As you can see, they work as support and resistance. Look here, here and here. So as they bend, they work as a support and resistance as well. I will show you in a moment. When you drag the line, but not here, you drag the line over here on this bend, and as well you drag the line here, you will see that in the future these lines give you the support, the resistance area and support area. As you watch here, look further here, is same story. You got higher band over here. So if you look into the future, you will see next resistance or next support area. It will be further somewhere over there, but you could see it works very nicely. You can check it out. So if you see the Bollinger Bands curves and goes higher, you might try to determine your support and resistance lines. That's the story, morning glory. So let's get rid of those lines, which are these ones, 1, 2, 3, 4. They are gone. So that's it. So the story is how to trade it. The story is that the market always tries to get the balance to come back to the middle line, middle Bollinger band. From the other hand, the market used to go up and down from that area, and you don't know where it's going to go. Usually what I do when I see this is a moving average, when you see a moving average and the market goes from the lower band to the middle of the Bollinger band, cross it, and the moving average is above, like here, so you might expect that the market will return to the lower Bollinger band, because we got the falling market here. This is the bear market. And different story when the band changes the direction. It's not here. Let's go back a couple of months. We will try to find the market. When the market is rising, it's same story. Look, as soon as the market crosses moving average, is above moving average, all the prices, usually the support area is a middle Bollinger band, as you can see here. And as soon as the prices cross it, you might say is going higher. Only this is the case when I told you that prices pretty often go over the upper Bollinger band when the market is moving up, is strong market, and when it's very weak, is different story, like here. So as you can see, this area over here, I make an arrow over here just to show you. Over here, this area, the price crossed lower Bollinger band and crossed the moving average as well. That's the reason why we got this waterfall. This is for our chart, so it's pretty big move. It sounds like, well, it's 560 pips, so it's pretty big. So whatever, that's the story. So I encourage you to try to work your settings of your indicators. Very easy, you will find your probable support and resistance areas, not only by dragging the line on tops or bottoms, but also dragging the lines on upper and lower Bollinger band when it curbs. It gives you a better look. And when the price comes in the area of the middle line, be careful, because when you got something like that, the price approaches, and like here, it hits the line and comes back. You got the edge. You got 70% or 66% chances that the market will drop to the lower Bollinger band. And that's it. That's all the story. Well, it's not very complicated. So let me tell you now what the settings are. As far as I know, moving average is 1,200. That's the setting. Why? We got for our chart here. So 1,200, if we divide it by 6, because in 24 hours we got 6 4-hour candles. So we divide it by 6, we got something like 200 moving average daily. Yeah, there's daily 200 moving average. That's why it's 1,200. And the Bollinger band settings as well is 450 instead of regular whatever it is. I don't even remember. I don't use that. So guys, this is a very simple method. Just enjoy it. I hope I helped you. Once again, I encourage you to get your settings and work it, trying to find different settings on the bigger time frames. If you are on 1 hour chart, try to put something like 500 or 1000 or 2000. You will get the moving average daily on 1 hour chart. It will help you much more. Same story with Bollinger Bands. Try to work with deviation. I got 2.2, usually it's 2. When you put deviation, smaller one, you make 1.5. It's a different story. Oh, look, it's look different. Try to make it 2.4 or 2.5, 2.7. Let's do it 2.5, and you will see it's much better. The price just barely touched the bands, you see. So it's much more reliable, and you can count on it more. Guys, I hope it helped. Don't forget to subscribe. Give me a like button if you like. Just write me in the comments, what would you like to see? I gladly will help you, and all my experience is for you. Just write in the comments what you'd like to see. I'll do one video just for you. Thanks for watching, and have a good one. Green peeps.